just talking to you as if you're either or neither. But to charismatics, I want to say tongues are not everything. Charismatics have made too much of tongues. And in two particular ways, they have made two assumptions which I don't think Scripture bears out. First assumption, that tongues is the only possible evidence for baptism in the Spirit. I don't believe we can establish that from the New Testament. That it is an evidence is very clear. That it's a frequent evidence is also clear. That it's the only evidence is not so clear. Because in fact, there are other things mentioned in the book of Acts when they received the gift of the Spirit. Prophecy is mentioned, and that's in your own language. And praise is mentioned, spontaneous praise is mentioned. And that could be in your own language. What is common to all of them is that there is a spontaneous expression from the mouth every time. And that's understandable because the mouth, says Scripture, is the overflow of the heart. And whatever your heart is full of spills out of the mouth. That's a principle I hardly need to persuade you of. When you're full of fun, you laugh. I've heard you laugh today. And I could hear it from here. I knew it had happened. I knew you were full of fun because it exploded in laughter. And when you're angry, you shout. And when you're sad, you howl. And when you're frightened, you scream. And Jesus said, if your heart is full of dirt, it'll come out here. Whatever the heart is full of comes out of your mouth. How do you know when your petrol tank is full in your car? When it overflows. And God has given us each an overflow. It's a little hole about an inch below your nose end. So if you put your finger on your nose end and work down, you'll hit it. That is, it overflowed once or twice there. Thought it might do more, but anyway. Hey, a little more, good. You see how we overflow naturally when we're relaxed, when we're not trying to keep things in. Whatever we're full of comes out of the mouth. And I noticed that in every case in the New Testament, when they were filled to overflowing with the Holy Spirit, came out of the mouth in some way. But it wasn't always tongues. And above all, there is no clear statement in the Bible to say that it must be tongues. And in the absence of any clear statement, I can't be dogmatic where Scripture is not. On the other hand, you can make it so vague that nobody knows whether it's happened or not. And in fact, always something happened at the time. And as I've said, it was usually, in fact, always in my study, it came out of the mouth. Because when you're relaxed and you're filled with something, out it comes. Of course, you could refuse to laugh and say preachers shouldn't make jokes and keep your face dead pan. But then you'd be just suppressing it and keeping it in when you're laughing inside. But if you're a normal, natural, relaxed person, out it comes. When you're full of anything, out it comes. Even just a delight, oh, you know, out it comes. You hear it at Wimbledon. You know, you hear thousands of ooh, or thousands of and just everybody naturally coming out with what they're full of at that moment, multiplied by 5,000 or whatever. You hear it echoing round, and the referee has to say, quiet please, begin. But what you're full of comes out of here. But to say it must be tongues is to produce a pressure on people that says, must I speak in tongues? I will never answer that question. If people say, may I say yes. But if they say, must I, that's introducing a legalistic note into what should be a liberating experience and is not, I think, backed up by Scripture. The reason why it comes out of the mouth, I'm sure, is that, well, let me tell you about the vicar who told his congregation, I'm going to show you that part of my body that causes me most temptation. Well, he got a very rapt audience, and then he went, because that little part of your body is the most difficult for you to control. Says James, it's set on fire by...
came with life. One of the misunderstandings when it comes to the Holy Spirit is also that there is a difference between experiencing the Holy Spirit and getting baptized with the Holy Spirit. I know many Christians who have repented toward God and have got a supernatural experience by that, the new heart, you experience when you repent. And they're like, whoa, now I have the Holy Spirit. Yes. The Holy Spirit is also in repentance. The Holy Spirit also works in baptism in water. But you still need to get baptized with the Holy Spirit. So there is a difference between coming to faith by the Holy Spirit. Nobody can come to God unless the Holy Spirit draws them. There is a difference between coming to faith by the Holy Spirit and getting baptized with the Holy Spirit. When Jesus was here on earth, he talked about repentance, but there was something he could not do. The new life was still not started. But after the cross, something broke. The sin was put on him. So we now could come in and get relationship to God by Jesus Christ. And when he rose up again, he came to his disciple in John 20:22, and he said, as the Father have sent me, I send you. Receive the Holy Spirit, and he blow on them. There, I believe they got born again, the new birth, the same way we experienced after the cross. They received the Holy Spirit. But he still says to those same people who he said received the Holy Spirit, he said to them, wait in the city until you get baptized with the Holy Spirit. So there is a difference between getting saved or coming to faith by the Holy Spirit and getting baptized with the Holy Spirit. And I see that many have misunderstood that.
Okay, I will just continue here. When you talk about speaking tongues, I believe when we baptize people in the Holy Spirit and disciple people have keys of weekend, I believe this is for everyone. This is for everyone. And this is the sign that you are filled with the Holy Spirit. There is other signs, joy, flow is flowing out of you and so on. But I believe speaking in tongues is that sign. By that, I do not say that those people who do not speak in tongues, they do not have the Holy Spirit. Because again, I have met people who saw God, who was repentant, who was praying to receive the Holy Spirit, and one day the Holy Spirit came and filled them up. But because they did not know what it was, and because they did not speak it out, because of wrong teaching and other things, they did not start to use it. But they had the gift inside of them. And then I meet them and say, hey, you already have it. Just open your mouth and speak. Come on. And they start, and and they're so happy because, wow, I have it. Yeah, you actually had it for a long time, but you did not speak it out. The same, actually, I think for me, when I came to the meeting first time, 22 years ago, I came in, I repented, I experienced the Holy Spirit came into me. I experienced like a light came into my body. I fall in the floor. I met God. It was so powerful. And I stood up there and my life was changed forever. Short time after, somebody prayed for me and say, open your mouth, speak in tongues. We pray for you to receive the Holy Spirit. And I'm a practical guy. I'm not a thinker in that way. I'm a practical doer. So I just opened my mouth and spoke. And there I started to speak in tongues. It was not a big experience. It was not something powerful. What I know today, I did not know at that time. I believe today that day, the 5th of April 1995, when I came in the church for the first time, I believe there I got baptized with the Holy Spirit. In that moment, I received the Holy Spirit. But I did not speak in tongues before 3-4 months later, when somebody prayed for me and said, open your mouth and speak. I had it in me, but I did not know I had received that gift, and I did not use that gift. So for me, it was not a strong experience when I started to speak in tongues. But I still started to speak in tongues and it became powerful for me. And I think for some of us, we have different experience. And I think the experience is, our experience are real, but sometimes we misinterpret our experience. Because I thought that when they prayed for me many years ago and I started to speak in tongues, I thought that I got baptized with the Holy Spirit, but nothing happened. So I thought that to be baptized with the Holy Spirit should not be a strong experience because I did not feel anything. But I know now that I actually did not get baptized with the Holy Spirit, that I just started to speak out what I already received. But I got baptized with the Holy Spirit some months before. And I believe that when you receive the Holy Spirit, there is a change happening. You cannot receive the Holy Spirit and continue being the same. When the Spirit comes into you, you are changed. You are changed forever. Some people experience that and start to speak in tongues right away. Some people experience that, but because of wrong teaching and understanding and discipleship and what they've heard, they do not speak in tongues. And later, they think they get baptized with the Holy Spirit, maybe do, or later they just speak what they already has received. And what, again, what I see, and then I can take some of your, what I see is that my experience was that when I started, it was 1 out of 20 who started to speak in tongues. Now it's 20 out of 20, if I have the time with them. Because you cannot just line people up and pray for them to receive the Holy Spirit, because there is something they need to go again before to receive the Holy Spirit, and that is repentance. That is salvation. That is faith in God, and we had to make sure of that. I heard somebody say that some people have seen my video go out on the street and baptize people on the street with the Holy Spirit, and then they think they need to do the same, and they go out on the street and lay hands on people to get baptized with the Holy Spirit. But it's really important. We do not baptize people with the Holy Spirit who are not repented. When you see me go out on the street, baptize people with the Holy Spirit, it's people who have repented, who have the faith. And what you are seeing me do on the street in America and South Africa and Brazil, I've never done in Denmark, actually. I've never been out on the street in Denmark and baptized people with the Holy Spirit. Why? Because I've never met believers on the street in Denmark. There's not so many. I've never met anybody who truly have repented and have not received the Holy Spirit like that. And I think it's really important to understand, because the Holy Spirit is the Holy Spirit. And if people receive something like speaking tongues without repentance first, without having changed their heart, I don't believe it's the Holy Spirit. And we don't want to mislead people. We don't want a wrong spirit to go in and so on. And I've seen it. And that's why I'm really worried about some of the things I see out there. When we talk about, if I have a group of 20 people in front of me, let's say, if I would pray for them, 10 of them have no church background, they have repented, I explain the gospel, I speak faith into them right away, you repent, I lay hands on you, you just being tongues, and we pray, and it happened like that with all 20. All 10 of them. Then there is some people who have a church background. Some of them I need to encourage. Oh, you must speak because of what they have heard before. Did they do that in the Bible? I don't know. But did they have church background in the Bible? No. Paul, he did not need to talk about baby baptism and wrong teaching about the Holy Spirit being poured out in baby baptism. Why? Because it did not exist at that time. So we need to deal with the real world. We need to deal with different people today than at that time. And the truth is that sometimes we need to encourage people to pray, and we need to explain people, don't be afraid, God is not going to give you a wrong spirit now. We pray and he will give you the Holy Spirit. We also sometimes need to teach people that, hey, you already have the Holy Spirit, you just need to use it. We have to explain people how it works and get some of those wrong doctrines out of the way. When that happened, you will see that many more people start to speak in tongues.